So here is your complete look of the Pro Football Hall of Fame class of 2018. Three first ballot members of this class, Urlacher, Lewis, and Moss. T.O. finally gets in his third year of eligibility. Brian Dawkins in his second. Jerry Kramer, Robert Brazil were senior finalists, and Bobby Bethard in as a contributor. Speaking of T.O., he took to Instagram and he posted this hat. So I guess he knew he was getting in at some point. You see the T.O. in the middle, Hall of Fame. Congrats to the Hall of Fame class of 2018. We are golden.
He's had that ready to go for a few years.
I think so. Been waiting to pull that one out. Your reaction to this class, JJ?
Finally, they got it right and put T.O. in, who I believe was a first ballot Hall of Famer. But I'm happy to see Jerry Kramer go in because he's a Packer. But I'm finally, they got it right because T.O. deserved it. He's a first ballot. And I feel like if they put Randy Moss in, you had to put T.O. in because T.O. is second and third in a lot of categories. And I'm happy for him, man. It's well deserved. I mean, I know everybody talks about off the field and bad teammate and this and that, but getting in the Hall of Fame is strictly what you do on the football field and the production that you put out there. And T.O. was one of the best to ever do it, and I'm happy for him.
And by the way, it's not like T.O. ever committed a crime. T.O., one of the greatest receivers ever. And a lot of people thought it had to be either or, either T.O. or Randy Moss. It's okay if you put both in.
No, it is. For me, I'm a little hurt, right? Tony Boselli's a guy. I know he went to USC, but he's a Jacksonville Jaguar. Played not as long, similar to where Terrell Davis played, a shorter career, but he was the best left tackle in the game during that time. He didn't get in, but I'm happy for Ray Lewis, Brian Urlacher getting two linebackers in, as well as Brian Dawkins. You don't see safeties and linebackers get in the way they did, so excited for those guys and happy. Just a little sad that the Jags didn't get a chance to celebrate, obviously, with Tony Boselli.
Interesting that there were five offensive linemen that made the final 15. That was the largest position grouping as far as the final 15 are concerned, and none of them got in.
And that's crazy because those guys are the reason that T.O. and Randy get those plays. Steve Hutchinson's another guy that didn't get in there. You have to let these offensive linemen go.
You know, and it's hard being an offensive lineman, man, because you got these skill position, man. Faces always on TV. Everybody knows them. So they're kind of always going to have that upper hand and be able to kind of get in there first. But you do need the dirty guys to do the dirty work.